Hello, hello everybody. And this is my new tank that I've set up. A 29 gallon that will be a planted, well, it already is planted, a guppy tank. But it is the cycle part I want to talk about. I think the cycle is where most people end up going wrong. And mind you, there is a difference between a cycle tank and a fully established tank. It takes months and months to be fully established. But with some of the right methods, you can pretty much instantly cycle a tank. So here's some of the things that we want to talk about. Now, if you don't have an established tank that you can have cycled media with, or you don't have something of those lines, it's going to take at least a month, 6 weeks or more sometimes. But this is where having live plants and otherwise an established aquarium can help you speed up the cycling process to, like I said, from 2 months to overnight. So what I've done here, this is how I do it. I'm going to be perfectly honest with you. I do not even own a test kit. I did years and years ago, but all these tanks I have now, I've never even tested the water once. As far as ammonia, nitrites, and nitrates. Because I can tell. Now, why? That sounds stupid, but you can just tell. You read the fish, you read the plants. I've done hundreds of tanks over the course of 30 years. So these are things that I've picked up. So I suggest, if you're new and figuring it out, I completely suggest and encourage you to get a test kit. And there may be times where I might have a problem and a test kit would be good, but I don't own them. So this is how I've always cycled the tanks. Now mind you, the plants play a very key role because they will start using up the ammonia, the nitrate. They use ammonia, nitrate, and nitrates and other minerals. They use up all that. But we're going to use a trick, like I said, to speed up this process. Now, EcoComplete claims it has beneficial bacteria in it already, and I put it in. I dumped all the water in. So the substrate never even got dry. So if that's true, then we're golden and ain't got nothing to worry about. But I've never used EcoComplete before. So what I have done is the ceramic biological media that came with this aqua clear, I put in an established tank. My plan was to use one of my other pre-sponge filters and use it, get a tank that's already cycled, take the pre-filter off that, and then put a new filter or a new sponge on the already cycled tank, and then put the old sponge that's already, the old intake sponge that was already cycled on here. But I ended up not going that route with my pre-filter sponge. I ended up coming up with something different. This foam block that I cut a hole in and just shoved it in. So it's not quite as, I don't know how you'd say it, refined. It's a little more crude, but anyway. What you will notice is I always start my tanks off by putting snails in. Snails, you can't kill them. Yeah, I guess you can, but not really. Not within reason. Look at that. There's some new little leaves already sprouting. In 2 days, those new leaves are not there when I planted these crips. So that is awesome. I'm not sure if the valves do anything in or not. But anyway, we have signs that plants are growing. And if the plants are growing, they're using up something to make that growth. And what it is, well, there's already EcoComplete, comes fertilized and is supposedly beneficial bacteria. I'm not, still not sure the validity of that. And it comes soaked in fertilizer. And I've also fertilized the tank. And everything is looking good. The snails are doing fine. Of course they'd be doing fine. So what we're going to do now is get that biological media. It's been sitting in there for a while now. So we come in here to this 75-gallon tank. And there is the biological filter media. Oh, it's already slimy and gross feeling. And that is exactly what we're after. All right. Now we've got that. We've got to get this in here just right. Push down in there. It is all completely under the water. All the media is. There are a few pieces of the bag that are sticking out, but the media is underwater. And so now that I have fertilized and I fed the tank, the plants are already growing. Now we have the seeded bacteria in there, and we supposedly, I don't know the validity of it, but supposedly EcoComplete has the bacteria in it that we're after, and we know we just added some of that. So the next thing we can do is add some fish. And the whole reason I set this tank up is to get some panda guppies out here in the front room that I can enjoy in a nice display type of tank. So, and you mind the first 2 or 3 weeks, even with the bacteria from the media that we used in the other tank, and even with the supposed bacteria that comes aboard the new EcoComplete right there, we are going to feed very, very sparingly. Just a little bit for the first few weeks. I mean, keep the, you want to make it so it can slowly build up. And we're just going to put like 3 or 4 pairs of guppies in here. And they're little panda guppies, and 29 gallons is a lot of water. So if we keep it 3 or 4 pairs and feed lightly, and we got a few little shrimp in here, that will get the tank well on its way to being established. So let's catch some guppies to put in here. Okay, so I have selected 3 pairs of pretty little panda guppies to start out this tank. So let's see if we can get this part in here, and then we'll talk about what we need to look for. And there we go. Oh, we have them. All right, so now we have our red snails and our pretty little panda guppies in their brand new tank. So when you're starting off a new tank and you have cycled media and you have substrate that is supposedly has the beneficial bacteria in it, but we're still going to keep a really close eye on these guppies and see if anything looks off with them. And I probably, this first week anyway, I probably still will have my wife use Safe. That's the same as Prime, just concentrated powder form. And that will turn, if there is any ammonia in here, it will turn it to ammonium, which will be less toxic to the fish. We'll still allow the filter to cycle. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to keep a close eye on them. I always like to overfeed normally, but we are definitely not going to overfeed. Now, like I said, I'm sure there'll be people that argue with me and saying I'm not doing it right. But I think my track record for success is pretty good. So this is how I do it. And when you start seeing plants already growing after 2 days, you know it's a good sign. And I'm just like anyone else. I'm anxious and want to see pretty little fish in my new tank I just set up. So we'll let this tank get itself established. I mean, it could take 2 months, 3 months. What is it? This guy's really nice. But, and then I think at first I was thinking orange shrimp, but now I'm thinking maybe blue jellies. I live in here with the pandas. They'll have all the baby shrimp, all that rock work to get into, and they'll be good. And so another thing kind of ain't ideal is until these plants grow in, there's not a whole lot for the fry, but 29 gallons is a pretty big tank for only 6 little mini miniature guppies, so I think there'll be some fry still make it, even while the plants are still growing in. But this valve, when it gets real long and thick, is a very good environment for guppy fry to hide in and survive. Eventually, like I said, shrimp and a pluck will be added, but that is in the future. We'll keep an eye on this. Hopefully everything goes good. I think it will. This ceramic media is already slimy and gross feeling. It looks clean. It is all covered in slime and been in that filter. And the tank that has been going as is for probably 3 years, so I think that'll be all right. So there it is. I instantly cycled this tank. I'm still not sure on the eco-complete part. But I know using seeded media works. And just in case, when I am gone for work this week, I will have the wife. I leave Monday, I'll dose it Sunday night, then I'll have her dose safe Tuesday night, and then I'll be home Thursday to check on it. Just in case there's a little bit of ammonia, that will neutralize it and turn it into ammonium. It binds a molecule or something or other, an atom. I'm not a scientist. I guess actually I'm a computer scientist. I have a degree in information technology. But anyway, I'm not that kind of a scientist. And I get into that kind of stuff sometimes, but I don't know at all. I can't rattle it off the top of my head. So I'm not going to do it. Just know, they're so fast, they're hard to follow. Just know this should work. It's worked lots of times before, minus the eco-complete part. So we're good. You just gotta be careful and cautious the first few weeks. Then once you can tell things are gonna be good by how the fish are acting. See any funny signs from the fish, it's time to add some safe to neutralize that ammonia. Okay, everybody. Thank you all for watching. I know this is one of the more confusing things about starting a tank, and I probably didn't shed a whole lot of light on it. If you guys have any questions, I really do know what I'm talking about. So, if you have any questions, or just leave them in the comments and I'll get back to you. So, this is how I do it. I'm not saying it's the only right way, but it works. So I know it is one of the many right ways to cycle a tank. Thank you guys for watching. Bye.